Hallelujah.
Praise. Praise the Lord. Let us stand, please. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, that you may be also. The Lord don't know where you are going. How can you know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believe in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And he that liveth and believeth in me, he shall never die. Amen. So we have the seats to the front. We are at 25% capacity. And in the event that any family member should come in and relax, our members, if they could please go to the, we have a room, some room in the back on the outside, but we are trying to maintain this 25% capacity.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer.
Find a friend.
Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every need. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. At this time, we will have the opening prayer. I want to invite Pastor Princess, who will come and for the opening prayer this evening.
Thank you, Pastor Rodriguez. I want to say good evening to each and every one of you that are present here today. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for this day that we have come together to celebrate the life of Ina Rogers Lampkin. Father, we thank you for strength. We thank you for spared life for all those who have come, family from far and near, to join as we celebrate her life, that she had been with us on this earth. Today is the day that she'll be leaving this earth, not in present, but in her body. I pray, Lord, Holy Spirit, that you're going to take full control of everything that's going to be said and done this evening in your house. Continue to strengthen the family, the husband, the children, each and every one that is here, the well-wishers, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you're going to give them the strength that they need. Father, for you said in this time we ought to mourn with those that mourn and weep with those that mourn, that weep. Father, we thank you for this day. Father, we thank you for everything that you will do for this family, Lord. And we know that her life is just finished on earth, but she's in a better place with you, dear Father. Continue to give us the strength. Give them everything that they will need, the courage and the patience to go through this time of grief. In your name we pray, amen and amen. I turn over to Pastor Rodriguez.
Thank you, Pastor Princess. This evening, I want to welcome each and every one, those from abroad, those in Trinidad, friends, well-wishers. On behalf of my apostle, Pastor Tony Hamilton, and Pastor Princess Hamilton, we sincerely express our condolences to the family. We know this is a challenging time. For some, there might be mixed reactions. For the younger ones, they might be questioning what is happening. But as the song says, you know, Jesus has the answer. Jesus knows it all. So at this time, I want to invite the worship team to lead us in worship this evening.
Thank you, Pastor Rodriguez. We want to sing How Great Thou Art this evening on your leaflet, on the brochures, you'll see it, amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder that pass throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be lifted up. You are worthy to be magnified. You are worthy to be glorified. Hallelujah. And when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair, when the saints on earth shall gather over home beyond the shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, and when all the saints shall gather over home beyond the shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the road is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Soon we are going to see the King, hallelujah. Soon and very soon we are going to see the King, hallelujah. Soon and very soon we are going to see the King, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more dying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more dying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more dying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. Very soon, we are going to see the King, hallelujah. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King, hallelujah. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more crying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more crying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah. No more crying there. We are going to see the King, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are going to see the King. If I should die in a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. If I should die in a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Yeah. If I should die in a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. If I should die in a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Oh, 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 oh. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Now, if I should die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Yeah. If I should die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. Oh, 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 oh. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. Heaven, heaven, heaven is my home. I wanna sing, sing, sing. I wanna shout, shout, shout. I wanna sing, I wanna shout. Praise the Lord. When the gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus. I wanna sing, I wanna shout. Praise the Lord. We gonna walk all around God's heaven and meet the loved one who has gone on before. We gonna sit by, keep and come everywhere where we need to find no hope. Come let us sing, sing, sing. Come let us shout, shout, shout. Come let us sing and let us shout and praise the Lord. When the gates are open wide, I'll be singing my Jesus. I wanna sing, I wanna shout, praise the Lord. We gonna walk all around God's heaven.
apart. And meet the loved one who has gone on before. We're going to sit by the bank of the man, where we need to part no more. I say to leave your burden down by the Savior's side. Down by the Savior's side. Down by the Savior's side. I say to leave your burden down by the Savior's side.
Hallelujah, as the song said, carry them no more. You may have your seats now. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Once more again, we want to welcome you to Resurrection Life Revival Assembly. You know, we are here to celebrate the life of our dearly departed sister. And for some, they might wonder, how come at a time of death that these people are celebrating and rejoicing? Well, we are celebrating and rejoicing because we know that our sister is in a better place. Hallelujah. She does not have to worry about pain or sorrow or nothing of the sort. The Bible says that to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. So had she been living a life unknowing to God, there would have been an occasion, you know, to worry. But knowing that she knew the Lord, she had a relationship with the Lord, we have all reason to celebrate. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So at this time, we, according to the program, we want to have the eulogy. Who will be? Are you all ready to do the eulogy at this time? Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, you can welcome her as she comes. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, saints. Today, I want to welcome you. Welcome the family, the friends, loved ones, the well-wishers. I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And today, we are gathered here today to celebrate the life of our sister, our niece, our mother, our grandmother, our wife, indeed. And we thank God for Ina. Brethren, I just want to give you a little, share a little of what I know so much about my niece. She was the third child in a family of seven. And saints of God, brothers and sisters, well-wishers, Ina was a jovial, provoking, nobody escaped the provoking spirit of Ina. She either make you vex or please. And when I remember these things, this is what's going to bring a joy to me, and it should bring a joy to us as well. Because I remember my mother sharing with us when my sister was having her how sick she was, and they had to take her to the hospital. And when they found out she was having this baby, but the baby was in the tube, what we call an ectopic pregnancy. And my mother had to sign, because the doctor said, to save your daughter's life, you had to sign first to do the surgery. But the doctor said to mommy, I'm giving your daughter 2 tablets, and I'm waiting for 15 minutes. And if the baby doesn't move, then we have to do surgery. And my mother said, when it was 15 minutes, the doctor came to her. She said, the baby moved and went in its rightful place. That baby was our loved one, Ina. And you know that it was only God could have done that. And she just didn't survive that. She went to term. And God extended that life to 60 years with us. And we give God thanks for that. 60 years on this earth. Not only being a wife, but was able to have children and to see grandchildren. But saints of God and brothers and sisters, well-wishers, Ina was so provoking and make you laugh. She used to tell my mother, she said, grandmother, I found out you went to sign to kill me to save your daughter, but is the Lord have me here? And of a truth, it only God could have kept and saved her life. I mean, when my mother used to just smile when she would provoke her and tell her, you signed to take my life, but God saved me. And no one escaped Ina's provocation, no one. Whether it's the uncles, whether it's the aunts, whoever, she would do it. And when I remember these things, I really would smile, because she was a loving niece, a kind niece, willing to do anything, a very clean young woman. Willing to keep a house. When she finished with her house, make sure you know where to pass, because you will get in trouble with her. I'm telling you, you would have gotten in trouble with her. Many times my sister vexed, Auntie, don't pass there. I just cleaned there. That is the Ina we knew and the Ina we grew to love. And brethren, when I remember these things, it really brings a joy to my heart. And I pray God that her husband, her children would remember when the sadness would come, remember who she was, a joyful person. Remember that, and that sadness would move away. We give God thanks today for that, our sister, that we know she is in a better place, as we have heard. We know that she's in a better place. And I want to quote a verse in a song. It says, the name of the song is Until Then. He said, let our hearts go on singing. Until then, with joy we will carry on. Until the day our eyes behold that city. Until the day God calls us home. Because we all will get that call. Someday it would be for you and for me. And we thank God her time has come. And we bless God for the time that she spent with us. And when we ever want to think about our sister, about our niece, about your wife, about your mother, remember she was a loving soul to you all. A kind and daring young woman. And today, I say thank God for her. She is in a better place. No more pain. No more sorrow. And I really want to thank God for her companion. Because whenever he would video call me, and he said, talk to your niece. And I thank God that he was there by her side all along the way. It is a blessing indeed. And Lampin, your blessing is sure. Many people don't do these things. Your blessing is certain. And for a little young lady that Ina grew up, her name is Muffin. I thank God for her. Thank God for her sons. Thank God for her sister-in-law, for those that the Lord used when she needed them most. I say, thank God. When we do things, when we do the right thing, God always made provision for us. And he made provision for her when she couldn't help herself. And for that, we all say thanks. And with these words, be encouraged. We will all meet her one day because Ina's heart, mind, and soul was on the Lord. Everything she said, Auntie, is only Jesus. It's only Jesus now, it's only Jesus. When you could give it all over to the Lord, you know all is well with you. So God bless us all in Jesus' name.
Thank you very, very much. Very encouraging indeed. Let that be an example for each and every one of us, you know, that at the end of our day, that there will be something like that said about us. You know, we love God and we demonstrated that love. Because love, it conquers everything this evening. Now, before I continue, I apologize for not doing it earlier, but some of you may have found out by now. First of all, we have one exit and entrance in the building because the door at the other end is locked. So in case of an emergency, we will all proceed calmly through the door that you came in. Amen? Also, the washrooms, they are through the sliding door. You turn left. The male or gents is on the right, and the ladies will have to walk a little further to the left. Amen? So in case you have to go. Thank you very much. So at this time, I want to ask you to just, you know, bear the time in mind. At this time, we want to open the floor for anyone who wants to say something to encourage the family, you know, to say something about our dearly departed sister at this time. So the floor is open at this time. Just remember to make it short. Thank you. Amen. So the floor is open at this time. Okay, so at this time we have a special song at this time. We want to invite Sister Crystal Tinia, who will come and bless us with a song. Sister Crystal.
A pleasant good evening to all. A special good evening to our Apostle and First Lady, and my deepest condolences to the Lamkin family. This song was chosen by Mr. Lamkin himself, and the name of this song is Stay With God. No matter what we are going through, always stay with God and put him first. Hallelujah. I know the mountain gets so high sometimes. I know the valley seems so wide. It seems this journey, it will never end. And you keep asking God question, God why? I know the road, it gets so rocky at times. I know the heartache is severe. It seems like life will never change its style. But there's an answer to all of life, yeah. Stay with God in spite of what you see or feel. Stay with God in spite of how things may appear. There is only one place we are safe. Stay with God. I know the way you feel says give up now. I know you feel you can't hold on. You're not the only one who is carrying your load. Remember he said to cast all your cares on him. I know you cry and tell everyone you meet. Because you feel that weight is the pain. But if you just believe your life is in God's hand, then today I tell you, your mountains have to disappear. Stay with God in spite of what you see or feel. Stay with God in spite of how things may appear. Stay with God, it doesn't matter what may come your way. There is only one place we are safe. Stay with God. Stay with God in spite of what you see or feel. Stay with God in spite of how things may appear. Stay with God, it doesn't matter what may come your way. There is only one place we are safe. Stay with God.
Hallelujah. What a fitting tribute indeed. Stay with God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. It's all right. It's all right to express your feelings at this time. Hallelujah. We are told to weep with those who weep, mourn with those who mourn, and rejoice with those who rejoice. Even Christ, at one time he wept when he looked at his friends and his family, how they were weeping, because they missed that person who would have been part of their lives. So it is okay. It is okay to pour out your heart. Hallelujah. But just remember the words of that song, Stay with God. I would like to ask you to rise at this time just for a brief moment. We are about to receive the word of God, and help me to welcome our apostle this evening, Apostle Tony Hamilton, at this time.
Good afternoon, and please be seated. Special welcome to you, to our humble sanctuary. Let me give condolences on behalf of my wife, our church, all of our family members, to the Lamkin family. This family, amen, I've known particularly Mr. Lamkin for several years now. I didn't know his wife too much until some months ago she began to attend our church. You know, on a Sunday she would come, until one day somebody came and they said, Pastor Tony, are you aware that this is Mr. Lamkin's wife, and she stayed with us until the COVID sort of separated us. Today we know, today is a lot of mixed emotions in the house because somebody lost a sister, some lost a wife, amen, some lose a mother, and as Pastor says, it's okay to weep, and I want to thank God for our team today, my wife, Pastor Princess, Pastor Rodriguez, Elder Gillard, and the musicians, the worship team, and the ushers, not forget the ushers, amen. And I know today is a bittersweet sort of feeling, but for those who live with her all these years, I could well imagine the feelings. But today I'm here to come to let you know that it's not the end. It's not the end, Brother Lamkin. Amen. She just changed lives. She gone to a new place. You know, very young, while I used to be, when I got saved, and the pastor taught us about heaven and hell, and there's a life, there is a land beyond this land. I used to sing a song from that old Melody of Praise, that songbook. Mind you, I've been around now for the past 40 years around the church. And I learned this song, and I want to try to sing. You know, when you're preaching now for a number of years, your voice gets very croaky. So you can't sing like these sisters and Brother Gillard. But I want to try to sing a verse of that song to encourage you today, to let you know that the land she has gone to is only a matter of time. We're going to join her there. Amen. Hallelujah. There's a land beyond the river that we call the sweet forever. And we only reach that land by faith, you'd see. One by one we dream the portals. She's gone to live with the immortals. When they ring that golden bell for you and me, oh, can't you hear them bells now ringing? Can't you hear the angels right now welcoming her home, man? Come on, sister, come home. Can't you hear the angels singing? It is a glory, hallelujah, jubilee. In that far off sweet forever, just beyond that shining river, when they ring that golden bells for you and me. When our days shall know its number, amen, when in death we sweetly slumber, when the King command our spirit to be free. Nevermore no heavy laden, we have reached our lovely Eden. When they ring that golden bells for you and me, oh, can't you hear them bells now ringing? Can't you hear them? Can't you hear the angels singing? It is a glory, hallelujah, jubilee. In that far off sweet forever, just beyond that shining river, when they ring that golden bells for you and me. I learned this song in my first year in church. There is a land beyond this land. There is a city that John saw in the book of Revelation, chapter 22. Amen. He said he saw a new heaven and a new earth. Amen. And the old heaven, the old earth was passed away, and there was no more seas. And he gave the size of that city. And today as we speak, Sister Ina is over there. Amen. It's okay to cry. But sooner or later, we have to join her. None of us here come to Tunstone. And sooner or later, we have to join her there. And I believe she's going to welcome us home. And the angels are going to clap and they're going to sing for us as they sang for her some days ago. Amen. Let me just take a few moments. We are trying to keep within the confines of the time. And I guess that will give us about 10 more minutes to conduct our service here. I want to borrow this evening's scripture from the book of Job. Amen. Job chapter 14 and verse 1. I will jump to 8 and then I'll go to verse 10. Let me just say that Job, when the Bible was compiled together, Job ended up before Psalms. But Job lived in the days of Abraham. He was an Old Testament guy, amen. But you all would know the story. One day Job got sick. Amen. And his sickness disfigured him beyond recognition. That when his friends came to visit Job, for days, when they saw his condition, nobody spoke to each other. Amen. And they sat and they looked at Job, and Job looked at them, and nobody spoke. But in this man's situation of disease, of sickness, of ailment, he began to ask God some question that we need to understand this afternoon. You certainly remarks, Job cursed the sun, he cursed the moon, he cursed the stars, he cursed the day he was born, he cursed the womb that brought him forth. And one day God said, Job, he said, where were you? God stopped him, he said, where were you when I called this earth into being? Amen. And Job came to himself and he recognized, amen, that his situation, amen, it is in the hands of God. And today our sister, her soul is in the hands of God. And don't worry, cry and weep, yes. We all are emotional beings, and when we lose a loved one, we have a way we respond, amen. We emotions kick in and we begin to cry. But hear me, amen. We were there, amen, with her in the last season. But the Lamb can call us once or twice, and we prayed with her, and we were trusting the Lord for the labor. We have seen God heal cancer people in this church. We have testimonies, and I shared one in the week about a young lady who we prayed for, and all her hair dropped off. But the Lord has the final say this afternoon, amen. And today I want to just, you know, read a little scripture for you to encourage your heart this evening. When Job became sick, he began to ask him some questions, and he said, certain remarks, and he said, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. He come like a flower, amen, and is cut down, he fleeth also as a shadow, and continueth not. He said, who could bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Seeing our days is determined, amen, the number of our months, or his months, are with thee. Thou hast appointed our bounds, and we cannot pass. He was saying there is an appointed time for us. God gave us a certain time on this earth, and it's very important for us as human beings to live that time span we were given well. And let me tell you something. This sister Ina today, she's preaching to us, you know. If you listen carefully, you'll hear her saying to us, she said, one of these days, amen, you'll be in that box where I lie. And a preacher gonna be preaching, and a team gonna be singing, and somebody gonna read the eulogy. Right now she's speaking to us, and I believe if she had a word, she would have said, get ready. Be ready. You know, we prepare for everything else. As I said last night in the week, except for death, we prepare for everything else. But Job began to ask some serious questions. And he described man as a flower. Man is a spirit. He has a soul. But he lives in a body. And I said to you last night in the week, when God created man in the Garden of Eden, from the dust of the ground, the scripture says, man had eyes, he couldn't see. He had ear, he couldn't hear. Man had mouth, he couldn't speak. Amen. And the Bible says God did something miraculous. He breathed into man nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. What did God do? God placed a part of himself in man. And all happened at the point of death. God take back what he blew. But you know, God gave man a soul. Man, amen. God is, amen, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Man is body. Is this the end of her life? He said, the soul of the righteous is in the hands of God. And not, amen, and no torment will ever touch him. You missed a good time to say amen. The soul of the righteous is in the hands of the Lord. And he said, no torment will ever touch him. He went on to say, in the eyes of the foolish, they seem as they have died, and amen, and their departure was taught, and is a time of affliction, and they are going from us as destruction. So when the unsaved man sees death, he sees death as destruction and affliction and something evil. But the scripture says, precious in the sight of God is the death of his saints. Amen. Let me tell you something. I was in the U.S. some years ago. I visited this church in Long Island, and a pastor, Brother Richard, took me to one of their churches. And I met this Indian preacher, born and raised somewhere part of India. And after I was through preaching, he said, "Pastor, I want to tell you something. I have a testimony." And he being the host pastor, but he asked me for permission now. And I said, "But I want to hear that." He said, "Did you know I died?" And are you aware that there are several hundreds of persons who claim that they died and they came back to life? Amen. If you check, you would understand that there are persons all in Africa, people claim that they died and they went to heaven, some went to hell and they came back. Here's my testimony. He said, "Pastor," well, I forget, was it Bangladesh? I can't recall the village he used to live, but he said I was very poor. He said we couldn't even afford to buy food. He said several times we had one meal per day. He said some missionaries came and I joined the church with the Lambkin and I began to follow Jesus Christ. He said one day I grew in the Lord, I had faith in God, I was told about heaven, I was told about hell, I was taught about eternity. He said one night in a prayer meeting, this man just fall back while he was worshiping, and he claimed he died. If anything contrary, I said what he said to me in Long Island. He said, "Pastor, I fell back and I died." He said, apparently, "From the moment I fell out," he said, I lose connection with this world, with this life. He said, "I saw myself, amen, in a line, and there was this guy way long away from me, and he said on the both sides of the corridor, there were angels. He said, "You have never seen trumpets like this," and it was blowing. He said, "You have never heard harmony." He said, "Pastor, don't feel a lion." But you're talking this Indian, you have to listen to me to walk to this man on this chair. He said, "I was walking, going." He said, "It was blowing the trumpet." He said, "Talk about a song, amen." He said, "With harmony." He said, "I walked straight to this man on the throne." And the man said, "You have to go back." He said, "I've got some nations. I got to send you to some nations in the world. You got to go and preach. You have to go to Russia. You have to go to America." And he said, "The man on the throne called six nations. You have to go." He said, next thing he know, he wake up. And he said they were so poor, they wasn't in the reach of a doctor. So they was trying to resurrect him, and they was praying and saying, his name was Zachariah. "Raise up Zachariah. Raise up Zachariah." When he jumped up now, they was praying for him. And that man, he said, "Pastor," say, "when I stood before that man on that throne," he said, "I felt like 10,000 volts of electricity run through my body." He said, "Pastor, I've never seen a man spoke with such power. I've never heard a voice." Amen. But John the Revelator, he said in Revelation that when Christ spoke to him after he was cast on Patmos, that his voice was as the voice of many waters. The place shook. Amen. When Christ was speaking, and he said, "Pastor," that man said, "you got to go back." He said, "Go back. You're going to some nations of the earth to share this gospel." And he said, "Pastor, you know what? He said, America is the last place." The man hit every nation. He said, I told you earlier, amen, they are departed. And they are brought into affliction. And they are going from us is as destruction. He said, "But they are at peace." This is the word of the Lord. If this scripture is true this afternoon, our sister is at peace. I believe that some celebration took place for her, Brother Lambkin. When you all was crying that day when she died, amen, and the spirit of grief and sorrow came while you all was crying and in tears. On the other, in the next land, the land beyond the river, they was rejoicing. Let me tell you something. That land, amen, Jesus said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me." He said, "In my Father's house, there are many mansions." He said, "If it were not so, if you, come on. It is not the end. Glory to God. There is a place for the redeemed. Glory to God. Amen. There is a place. Amen. The righteous. Amen. The scripture said there is a place prepared." He said, "I got a place prepared for you. That where I am, there you may be also." Today, you know, you'll hear more of Pastor Rodriguez. Let me just say this, For the past few years, I've not been in a funeral service. I have my team normally goes out and all over Princess Town, wherever people call and say, Pastor Tony, come and do a funeral. They would go and they will represent the church. But after hearing this news, you know, the few times we have been in her house and we prayed, I'm going to love this family. You know, my other son sent me to the back there in the media room. Sometime we got to leave home and the mother would say, this is my wife here, by the way, Pastor Princess. The mother would say, son, where you going? And he said, mommy, I'll go by my second mother. And this man, Sister Ina, I lost my son, but Lamke, sometime 2-3 days, the man ain't come back. I'll talk to baby, you're very serious, but let the grief pass a little bit. A week sometime, this boy, he said, daddy, I'm coming tomorrow, come sometime, you would stay. And he said, daddy, don't worry, you know. He said, by my next mother. And for a woman to take up a stranger in her house, feed him, and make him feel so, amen, welcome, that he wants to go and spend 2-3 days. And mind you, it is not her alone, but this entire family, I believe, they got a good spirit, amen. I believe God has some special stuff to do for you. Amen. And for you to do for him. Glory to God. So as our time runs away on us, amen, I want to just pray for the family this evening. Amen. The soul of the righteous, the scripture says, is in the hands of God. To the foolish, they see his punishment and they see that as a bad thing. Glory to God. But let me tell you something. Precious, the scripture says, in the eyes of the Lord is the debt of his sins. When a righteous person die, angels get up. For over 40 years, Pastor, and you are fed up. I said, no, I ain't fed up. I just warming up. Amen. I just want to preach this gospel because there is a land, amen, for the redeemed. There is a place, amen, that God has prepared for us, the scripture says. And if we live a God-like life, let me tell you something. I don't want to hurt anybody, ruffle anybody feathers. But if you live like the devil, there's a place for you. Yes, if you live like Satan, amen. Let me tell you something. There are two kingdoms right now fighting for your soul. Amen. The scripture said in Colossians chapter 1, he said, God had delivered us from the powers of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his son. There are two kingdoms want you right now, but you have to choose which one you want to go. We were involved really point 14. We used to go all, amen, love until behind the St. Paul Street, behind the BSO station. We will land up there and we'll cry with all these big guns, Otogaro in them days from point 14. We more love bestows. I'm going to score this song, but amen. When you really connect to God and give him your life and give him your soul and you learn how to pray and to seek the face of God, let me tell you something. Amen. It prepares you for this kingdom. So I'll close. Our time is expired this afternoon. Amen. But I want to pray for the family. Could the family please stand? All the family, could you please stand? Amen. Please stand. It's right where you are. Through the COVID, we don't want to lay hands and touch anyone. And I want to call my wife again, and she's going to say a prayer for you. And let me just say, while we are viewing the body, we want to ask all the visitors to view first. There are some persons on the outside who love to view the body. So after you have viewed the body, please exit the building. And the last person going to view will be the family, so they'll have their time. Although we're looking at the hour and a half, but amen, this is a homegoing service. Why celebrate and sing and dance, somebody says? When somebody died, you're supposed to be crying and sad. No, it's a celebration, amen. We celebrate her life, her hard work, her relationship. We celebrate all that she did in this life. And as I said, the family will pass the picket hand over to Pastor Rodriguez, and he will give you will hear more from him, though, at the cemetery, though. This is the cemetery man, committed man, the comedy buddies, and the soul, the lambkin of the righteous, is in the hands of Jesus. Don't worry. Live the life, man. I know you said you want to come in the church and you want to serve him. Baby, you serve Jesus. And one of these good morning, you're going to be reunited with your mother. And the good thing about that, we will not have this mortal, sinful flesh and blood cannot go to heaven. Amen. You'll receive an immortal body. If you live that life, if you could please God, if you could serve God, one of these days you're going to sound the trumpet. The dead are going to rise. Amen. Incorruptible. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Come, Pastor Princess, and pray for the family and back over to Pastor Rodriguez and hear the close this service. Amen. Thank you very much. It was a very good audience, and may God bless you this evening. Amen.
Praise God. I want to say good evening again. I really want to thank God for this family. I really didn't visit as much as I should, but I grew to love this family through my son, JB, and baby O. Whenever he's by you all, I feel comfortable. I don't worry. Right? And I really appreciate, you know, your mom. She came a few times. You know, the lockdown had us so kind of way we couldn't visit and we couldn't. But God is good. God is going to give us our freedom one day. Amen? I want to thank God for you all. I pray that, you know, her heart desire for the few times she came with us, I could see that she, her heart desire is to serve God. And I want you all to serve God. If you all have to see her again, you all have to serve God. I want to appreciate her, is her sister from the U.S., some family that from the U.S. here. Okay, we want to say welcome to you all. It's so happy to have you all here. You know, the funeral really supposed to be Monday gone, but we hold, you know, they hold it for you all. So you all are special people. All of you are special. All of you that come to join us this evening, you all are special. You know, it's good to let people know how special they are, especially when they are alive, you know, because some people wait until they lose a loved one to tell them how much they love them. But we have grown to love this family, amen. And I pray that God, that love that you all have knitted together, it will remain. I want to tell you, because when a house lose a mother, it's not an easy thing. I'm saying this through experience. I have lost my mother when I was 9 years. I grew up without a mother. I grew up without a father. When I see people lost mothers, I feel it, you know. But I thank God, you know, she didn't leave none of you small, like how she left, my mom left us. 9 children. I was the eldest in girl, and very young, 9 years, from 10 years, I had to take responsibility as a mother in a house, you name it. A mother does everything, multitask, wash, cook, you name it, and have to go to school after. So I want you all to know, stay put with your father, you know. Don't not because the mother is not there, you know, you just want to do your own thing. The father is there, show him respect, just as all y'all show him respect, because I know sometimes the mother is what to keep the house together. Eh? Sorry for the men, I love you all, you all do your part, but mothers have something about that God bless them with to keep that home together. I want you all are young, handsome, watch me. Everywhere you go, dialogue with your father, especially now, right? Don't take it upon your own as mother that you just want to go where you want, you don't know where you all are, you know? Keep that respect, keep that love, and I know your mother will be pleased with what you all will do in time to come, amen? So I want to pray that God is going to keep you all, God is going to strengthen you all, amen? God is going to bless you all, and I know that once you put God in your life, everything is going to be okay, amen? So I want to say, Father, we thank you for this family, Mr. Lamkin, and all those that are representing the family here today. I pray for your strength. Because these days, Lord, we know that without you, we cannot do anything. We cannot do nothing. I pray, Lord, that you will continue that love that they have, that the mother have shared in that home, that love will continue. There will be nothing else that will come and separate this love from this family. I pray that you will draw them closer. Because we know the enemy is out to destroy family. But we pray that even though she's absent in body, Lord, we know that your presence could be with them today. I pray for your strength. I pray for your courage. I pray for everything that it will take for them to stand in the few days that is coming. In the lonely time, Lord, let them know that you are there, because you promised in your word that you will never leave us nor forsake us, but you're going to be with us to the very end. And I pray for your strength today, even those that come from Father, family, that even as they come to support this family today, I pray that when they have to go back to their home, Lord, you will carry them in safety, dear Father. I pray a special prayer, Mr. Lamkin. I know he will go through a tedious time, a lonely time in days to come, but I pray that you will let him know that there is a God that comforts the hearts of those that lost
and lose loved ones, their fathers. Strengthen him today, Lord. Strengthen his sons, his children, grandchildren, everyone, every family, Lord. I pray that you're going to continue to keep them, their father. We thank you for the word that was set forth from the servant of God today. Let it not go on deaf ears, O God, but help us to take heed of your word, because we know that your coming is very soon, dear Father. We thank you today. We thank you today, for we know that this day belongs to you. And as we celebrate the life of Sister Ina, Lord, we know that she is rejoicing. And her greater joy is to see that her loved ones come to know you, dear Father. Lord, bless them, I pray. And we ask all these things in other name, but in your most wonderful and precious name, the name of Jesus, the name which is above every other name. Thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. I turn over to Pastor Rodriguez.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Princess. So at this time, we want to have the viewing of the body, but I want, on behalf of the family, I would like to thank each and everyone for coming out this evening and for, you know, being here to support the family, you know, in their time of grief and loss. So at this time, we want to do it in an orderly way, right? We will come from the outside, view the body, and then you will exit through the center, right? So as we said before, we will leave the family to view for last. Amen? So, and from here, we will then proceed to the cemetery to do the final rites. Amen? So we could commence the viewing of the body at this time. Thank you all.
Amen. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Go on with the song.
So numb I can't feel anymore.
pray and you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on. Didn't know today would be our last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on. Didn't know today would be our last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on. Didn't know today would be our last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell.
With the open. Thank you. Praise the Lord. So we're about to commit our beloved sister. So let's take the final and we want to avoid the rain. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Fear not, I am the first and the last. And the living one. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I have the keys of death and Hades. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? Thanks be to God who gave us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. World. And it is certain that we cannot take anything out of the world. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor, but of thee, O Lord, in whom our souls do rest in hope. After labor comes rest. After struggle, peace. After life's fitful fever, this last sleep. Almighty God, we give you praise, we give you honor and glory. Father, we thank you for the life of our dearly departed sister. Lord, she has lived and she has blessed so many lives, and she leaves a legacy of love, of peace, and of unity. Father, we pray even at this time, Lord Father, that those who would have known her, Lord, that they would be strengthened, that you will give them strength, courage, will give them peace. Lord, even as they mourn, Father, Lord, that you will bring comfort to them. And we pray, Lord, that in time that, Lord, we will all get to understand death in a better way. But Father, until such time, Lord, I pray that you would give the families and all the loved ones, the friends, the neighbors, that strength and peace. Lord, that as they go along in life, that so this evening, Father, we say, have your divine way. We declare a blessing upon each and every member of the family, every friend, every neighbor this evening, Lord. All those who would have known her. And Father God, let your will be done this evening. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen and amen. I'm going to take the... Yes, I'm going to take the coffin for the final resting place.
For
as much as it had pleased Almighty God of His great mercy to receive unto Himself the soul of our dearly beloved sister here departed, we therefore commit the body to the ground. Commit the body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Ensure uncertain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. Admit unto his glorious body, according to the mighty working, whereby he is able to subdue all things to himself. And I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord henceforth. Blessed indeed, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. Almighty God, who by the death of thy dear Son Jesus Christ has destroyed death by the rest in the tomb, has sanctified the graves of the saints, and by his glorious resurrection has brought life and immortality to life. Receive, we beseech thee, our unfailing thanks for that victory over death and the grave, which he had obtained for us and for all who sleep in him. Keep us in everlasting fellowship with all that wait for thee on earth, and with all that are around thee in heaven, in union with who is the resurrection and the life, who reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, without word, without end. Amen. The grace of God, love of God, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen and amen.
Oh, Appreciation. Thank you.
See what am I?